Obviously, the first suggestion relative to this would be to exercise every vote that one has available to one in the next sets of elections. What else besides that do you recommend to those of us who are angry and who have been angry throughout this whole process?
Well, I enjoyed your special comment last night, Keith, and I want to focus on one particular suggestion you had about using the wonderful digital tools that are newly available for the reinvigoration of democracy. Now, they've been around for a while, but they're spreading far and wide, and more people are getting involved. We need to have an American Spring. You know, the Arab Spring, the nonviolent part of it, isn't finished yet. But we need to have an American Spring, a kind of an American Tahrir Square, nonviolent change where people from the grassroots get involved again. Not the, you know, not in the Tea Party style. That, you know, there are people who are genuinely upset in the Tea Party. I understand that. But that movement was funded with seed money from right-wing billionaires, the Koch brothers, and promoted on Fox News and turned into a stalking horse for this right-wing agenda that a lot of people have been trying to push on this country for a long time. What's sacrosanct for them is to have absolutely no tax increases on the wealthiest Americans. They're at a low level now. And to try to shrink down government so they can get it out of the way of powerful corporations and special interests so that they can have free reign. And the Supreme Court, of course, has now declared that they're persons and can make these secret contributions. I want to tell you, Keith, this country is in trouble. Our democracy has been withering on the vine. It really has been. This has been a going on for some time, but this is not an event that can be taken lightly. I know it's difficult to imagine that people who care about the values that this country was based on will rise up and get much more involved in the democratic process, but that is exactly what we need, and that is the only thing that can get our country back on the right track.
When I spoke my piece last night on this, I was inexact and admitted to being inexact because the ideas are not fully formulated for me to express them. I mean, there's a general sense of there are things to be done. There are clearly things that can be done using the internet to amplify them and to make it more rapid response. But what do you have any practical suggestions on this? Because I don't have them, and I'm thinking, you know, is it flash mobs? Is it donations? How do we use the internet to get people activated in some new way?
There are some groups that have been working very hard to figure out the best answers to that question. We need to hold the elected officials accountable. We need to use these tools to get people registered and get them to the polls and get them motivated. You know, almost 100 years ago, the great poet Yeats wrote the famous lines, "The best lack all conviction and the worst are full of passionate intensity." Mm-hmm. Those lines were written in a different era, but they exactly describe the disgusting spectacle that we have watched over the last several weeks as the full faith and credit of our country was indeed held hostage, and the ransom that was demanded was to do things that are extremely harmful to working people, to middle-income families, and to the economy of this nation. You saw how the markets reacted.
I have to ask this, and I know it's a sensitive topic, but a lot of the blowback in the last few days has been directed against the Democratic Party. It has, in fact, been directed against the President of the United States. And I think I know that your answer to this, but I'm going to ask it anyway. Do you think the president should be renominated by his party, and do you think he should be reelected by his country?
Well, I support him. I think that he will be. We've seen too many times what happens when the incumbent president of a party is challenged in the primaries. There's a law of third parties. There's a law of primary challenges to a sitting president. And I think that law of politics probably still applies. I hope that he and our country will take out on a new and more determined course. I support Barack Obama. I like Barack Obama. But we have got to have a more forceful articulation of the vision that our country needs to follow and the values that we hold in our hearts when we say, yes, we're going to educate our children. We're going to clean up the environment. We're not going to ignore the climate crisis. You know, the right wingers are playing the same game there that they've played on this fiscal crisis, saying that it's somehow not legitimate to talk about the real problems that we face. Where the economy is concerned, we should be talking about unemployment mm-hmm. and getting people back to work. And where the agenda of the country is concerned, we can't just turn it over to corporations and the wealthy. It's the very idea that if you give more money to the people at the top, they're going to be job creators. Well, the reason they're not creating jobs is because they can't sell the products that they make. And the reason they can't sell the products is because the people of this country don't have the money to buy the products. We need to get the economy working in a pattern that helps middle-income families and low-middle-income families and takes care of those who need government to be on their side and not given in to the demands of the wealthiest and most powerful.